Turning back to our top story today, the impact, the historic impact of Tropical Storm Hilary. Sunday marked the wettest August and wettest summer day on record for San Diego, breaking a previous record that stood for more than 150 years. Now, even as Hilary weakens, it is helping amplify rising temperatures across the central U.S. and winds in the northwest, increasing the potential of new fires. Joining us now is science educator Bill Nye. Bill, it's great to see you. Just how unusual was it? And let's just start with one unusual aspect after another. But how unusual was it to have a tropical storm hit Southern California?
Well, it's been 84 years, apparently. I don't remember it, but I've read the records. And so what we got, everybody, is this heat dome over North America, over the continental U.S., and let's say a high pressure system spin clockwise, and then you have this low pressure system coming up from the middle Pacific, Western Pacific. And so the two act, to me, they act like gears, enabling this storm to travel much farther north and much farther east than has happened in quite a while. So everybody, it's very difficult to tie any specific weather event to climate change. But if you like to worry about things, this is a great time. We have this huge heat dome, extraordinary humidity in southern U.S., and we have these very high winds in Hawaii, and then we have this enormous rainstorm. It came through here. I live in Los Angeles. I'm in Los Angeles right now. It came through here last night. It was raining hard. And the difficulty, everybody, of course, the roads get closed, things fall down, but it's expensive. We've got to clean this stuff up. And, of course, once in a while, there's a tragic event. But this may be the beginning of things, and people like to throw around the expression new normal. But it's not really, it's not going to be normal. It's just going to get worse and worse, probably. So what I would like you all to do, as hard-hitting investigative reporters at the Place for Politics, is get somebody, probably a young person, during this debate this week, to ask any of these guys and gal running for president what they're going to do about climate change. Back to you.
And so what is it that you think, and when you mention all of these different factors that we've been seeing, I mean, you can't hide it. You we're seeing it. How are all of these things interconnected? And what is it that we can all do to make a difference?
Okay, so they're connected because the world's getting warmer and most of that heat ends up in the ocean. And so what drives a hurricane or enables hurricanes or cyclonic storms is heat, warm water. You get above 26 Celsius, what have you, then the water can sustain the cycle that produces these enormous storms. And then the spin of the earth makes them spin. And so if you're on the right side of the storm, as seen on a map, you get higher winds. And that's what happened here in Southern California. So what we can all do about it, I say this all the time, is vote. You know, this perception that if you just recycle your water bottles, if you just recycle your newspapers, climate change will be addressed. That is not the case. And I'll tell you, between you and me, everybody's talking about this movie Oppenheimer. And this is what is an enormous government investment to create new physics, to come up with a new understanding of nature. What we need, everybody, is virtually unlimited electricity. And so if I were a king of the forest, what we would do is I'm not kidding. We would invest in fusion because there's so many organizations, universities, private companies working on fusion. Somebody's going to figure this out.
Hey, Bill, I think we should continue our conversation going forward. I really appreciate you being with us this morning. Thanks.
Thank you for your time. Watch out for young people. They're going to demand change. They're going to demand climate change. It reminds me of a certain age of the Vietnam War, where people just, we've had enough. We're going to demonstrate. You watch out. Young people are going to demand change. Thank you very much.